Before we get going, I want to show a clip. This is something you said at the last Republican debate that I want to talk to you about. Let's just show this real quick.
If I were sitting at home and watching this back and forth, I'd be inclined to turn it off.
Now, I thought that was a very interesting thing for you to say.
Wonder if they agreed with me. Huh?
Yeah, I think it's a fair... when I was watching, I thought, well, that's interesting. It must be impossible. You're out there. It's 11 total candidates. You have 3 hours. There's so much back and forth. There's these rules that if anybody's name is said, they get a chance to rebut. How has this process been? How hard has it been for someone like you who is, if you don't mind me saying, seems to be trying to frame yourself as a reasonable candidate? Is it hard to be reasonable when there's so much noise out there?
Well, you know, the first debate was a little bit different. It was more orderly, and that went well. The second one, you know what a demolition derby is?
Yeah.
I was just trying not to crash my car into
the
wall. The hardest thing about it is, you know, you get limited time. And, Seth, you know, you want to explain to people what you're all about, and it's hard to do it. And, but look, it's an amazing process. And, you know, my father carried mail on his back. His father was a coal mine. My mother, I mean, her mother couldn't speak English, and I'm on a stage with a bunch of people running for president of the United States. So, you know, don't gripe too much. There'll be more opportunities. There's like 7 more debates to go. Get ready, everybody.
Now, you are, you know, if we're being honest, you are polling very low right now. It seems like the candidates that are polling higher are saying more outrageous things. You have not been one to say outrageous things. Can you continue to survive on this campaign trail,
Seth,
not doing that?
As you know, having, you know, experience in New Hampshire, national polls don't matter right now.
Mm-hmm.
What matters is what happens a little bit in the caucus in Iowa, but then what really matters is what happens in New Hampshire. And right now, I'm in the top tier in New Hampshire in a very short period of time. And I want to be positive. I want to be a uniter. I'm not going to go out and say, you know, outrageous things or make promises that I can't keep to win. Because if I did that, I'd be violating my own principles. And if I lost by not being myself, I'll never forgive myself. If I don't win and I'm still being positive with good ideas and trying to bring people together and give people a sense of hope and purpose, then I will be a winner regardless of what happens. Yeah, I think I can emerge that way. I mean,
I hope so. It's nice to have a voice like yours in this circus. You ran briefly in 2000. You defined yourself as the Jolt Cola candidate and the sea of Pepsis and Coke.
Yeah.
Now it's, you know, obviously it's 15 years later. The Republican Party has moved to the right. Jolt Cola doesn't even exist anymore.
Kind of like the adult on the stage, right?
That's the adult. Some say. What soda are you now, I guess? What are you, RC? What is the adult drink?
Well, an awful lot of water, maybe a little G2.
Right, a little tea.
New Hampshire in 2000, you know, I started this for a while, and I was up there one night, and I was having this conversation with this woman, and she was very engaged, and we were talking back and forth, and I thought, this is going to be my chairperson in this town. Then she looked at her watch and she said, hey, what time do you think the candidate's going to get here?
Oh, that's not good.
That's when I knew it was time to leave.
Right.